It is time for Sonny and Finn's WrestleMania special episode.
Hello and welcome to the Sonny and Finn Show. This is our WrestleMania special. I'm Sonny, and with me as always is Finn Steele. How are you, friend?
Hello, I'm very well, thank you.
Excellent. Right, WrestleMania is this coming weekend. So much going on that we thought we'd take another episode to sort of talk about everything a bit more in depth, from NXT to the Hall of Fame ceremony, and of course WrestleMania itself.
Indeed.
We'll also talk about Raw from this past week, building up to WrestleMania. And there was a few matches on SmackDown as well that probably aren't worth talking about, but we will talk about them anyway.
Few matches indeed.
Three, to be precise.
Yes.
So WrestleMania weekend kicks off on Friday with NXT Takeover Dallas.
Woo!
I'm so excited for this show.
Me too. Far more than WrestleMania, to be honest. Although the weekend itself will be great, I'm sure. But yeah, some amazing matches that just blow my mind.
Yeah, it's amazing that these guys are actually in WWE and having these matches.
Yeah, it's so crazy.
I mean, they're matches that people actually want to see.
Absolutely.
The matches on WrestleMania, people are a bit like, okay, not really piqued my interest by having good build-up because it just hasn't been good.
No. These NXT matches are like basically dream indie matches.
They are. they really are.
Yeah.
So let's have a quick look at the card for NXT. So the Austin Aries versus Baron Corbin. I've got a list of matches here. Obviously, not necessarily going to be the order that they're actually in on the card. But
sure,
judging from this, they could very well be.
Yeah,
so we've got Austin Aries versus Baron Corbin.
Yes. Baron Corbin's come a long way.
Big time.
He's improved a hell of a lot in the ring.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to this match. Austin Aries is great, obviously.
Yeah.
He's been great for a long time.
So, I mean, I didn't like Baron Corbin when he first came in. He's obviously started off they wanted him to be a face, clearly.
Yeah.
Like, the fans were sort of getting into it, counting along with his matches, how long it was going to take for him to beat the poor guy that he was put in there with.
Yeah.
You know, usually he'd be over in about 15 seconds.
Yeah.
A couple of punches. End of days, 1, 2, 3.
Yeah. It's a good way to get someone looking strong.
But how quick did the Full Sail crowd turn on? It's like, oh my God. It's like a week, and then it's like, boo!
Yeah. Like, one week is getting cheered, next week, instant booze. Like, what happened?
It's like it just clicked with the fans 1 week, where it's like, wait, we don't hate this guy.
Yeah.
This guy sucks.
That's a 15-second match, like 5 weeks in a row.
Yeah. It's like, put him in there with someone good, or we're just going to boo him.
Yeah.
Didn't put him in there with anyone good.
No.
Fine, we're just going to boo him.
Yeah, I think he had a feud with Bull Dempsey.
Bullfit.
Yeah, Bullfit. Mm-hmm. That's been pre-Bullfit before he even had a proper gimmick.
That's true.
A fat guy.
Yeah, that was awful, by the way.
It was pretty bad.
I know he's been released. I know he's been on the last couple of NXT shows that were pre-taped. And I think he's on this week's as well.
He is against Samoa Joe.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. So, I mean, I'm assuming we won't see him again after that.
No. I think it's long gone, sadly.
But either way, Baron Corbin, he really has come a long way. He's probably, along with Joe, the best heel in NXT at the minute.
Yeah, definitely. The thing he did when he attacked Austin Aries and, like, threw his t-shirt at William Regal was great.
Yeah,
it was awesome. That's awesome.
So, I mean, he's built up this feud with Regal. Austin Aries made his big sort of debut reveal at the shows that weren't taped at Full Sail. They were taped at another university in Florida. So Austin Aries came down, didn't even make it to the end of the ramp, and Baron Corbin came out, attacked him from behind. And then sort of gave William Regal the eyes and sort of said what Finn just said and threw the t-shirt at him. The week after on NXT, when they were back at Full Sail, they did like a live interview with Austin Aries at his house or wherever. And obviously Austin Aries then challenged Baron Corbin and Regal made the match. I think this could be it has potential.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
To be a really good match.
Yeah, I think it will be. I like Baron Corbin's character as well. It's like perfect evolution of his character. He hates indie guys, and that makes sense because he was just like chosen out of, I think he was like football player or something.
Yeah, he was in the NFL.
Yeah, and he was, as you said, he was supposed to be like a good guy, and he started getting booed, and like the indie guys started getting cheered. So it makes sense that he would hate the indie guys. So it's perfect character for him. It's great.
I mean, who do you think is going to win the match?
I think Austin Aries will, because he's new, and I think I'll want to give him a push and show him what I can do.
I agree. I think Austin Aries will win. However, if Baron Corbin was to win, I don't think it'd be the worst thing in the world.
No, it'd be fine.
Because what Baron Corbin's done so well, he's taken a bad situation and made it, he's made it into something that's better than how he started, if you understand what I mean.
Definitely, yeah.
So he's gone from sort of wanting, the obviously WWE wanted him to be cheered. It didn't work. They booed him out of the building. And now he's changed it. He's sort of flipped it on its head. And now he's a real good, solid heel.
Yeah, he's very good.
So I think Austin Aries will win as well. But it wouldn't be the worst if Baron Corbin won.
No, he'd be fine. If we just extend the feud out of it, which, again.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Aries has got to start somewhere. Can't just sort of have him fight Corbin once and then that's it.
Yeah.
They probably will have this match again.
Probably.
But yeah, I think Austin Aries wins.
Yeah, same.
The tag team division in NXT has been awesome for ages now.
Yes.
The current NXT tag team champions are the Revival, which is Scott Dawson and Dash Wilder.
Yeah.
Oh, I can't never get that right.
I know, I'm the same.
Just can't say their names. It's crazy. They've had a feud with Enzo and Cass.
Mm-hmm. Very good feud.
Very good feud. That finished at Roadblock.
Yeah.
In another excellent match.
Great match.
I know that made you like the Revival more.
Yep, I definitely fancy them now. They'll show me their potential and I think that could be huge. Still not the name though.
I don't really like the name. I think the Revival, is it called that because they're reviving some sort of forgotten style of wrestling?
Yeah, I think it's like just bringing back the old school style of tag team wrestling kind of thing.
Because I know their tagline was sort of fists, not flips.
Yeah, because I quite like that. That's a good tagline.
Yeah, which is cool. I'm glad they didn't go with that as a tag team name, because that would have been classic WWE. Okay, so they're fighting American Alpha.
Yay.
Jason Jordan and Chad Gable.
Big fan of them.
Big fans. I mean, I sent a tweet out about, it's probably Chad Gable had his first match on NXT.
Mm-hmm.
And he put on a really good show at that point. Like, had a really good outing. And I remember tweeting, like, Chad Gable could potentially be massive.
Yeah.
I did retweet it fairly recently. I found it and retweeted it fairly recently. Nice. Just to show my prediction. But they've come a long way.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Especially Jason Jordan, who's kind of, he's been there for a while, didn't really get hugely popular. But ever since he's been tagging with Chad Gable, he's just exploded and he kind of just shows what a good teammate can do, really, isn't it?
Yeah. Boy. I mean, the closest comparison to the team, and it's such an obvious comparison, is obviously the world's greatest tag team.
Yeah, yeah. From Kurt Angle's old table.
Charlie Haas and Shelton Benjamin.
Yeah. It makes sense.
Yeah, I mean, they look like, the same sort of ring attire. Jason Jordan's a black guy, Chad Gable's a white guy. and obviously the fans recognise that as well, because obviously they were chanting their names in the Kurt Angle theme song style.
Which is great. I love it.
Yeah, it's cool. And you can just see how much they've grown as a team, like in confidence and everything else.
Yeah.
And they're easily two of the most popular guys on NXT now.
Definitely.
I mean, I'm not a big tag team fan. No. I never have been, really. But I really get excited for their matches now.
Yeah, they're really good. I don't mind tag team matches, as long as they have actual believable teams.
Mm.
It's not like just two people thrown together, like Goldust and R-Truth, for example.
Yeah, okay.
But yeah, I think they'll be good. It's going to be a great match, either way.
Who do you see winning?
Good question. Tough one. Probably American Alpha, because they're so popular at the minute, and it would make sense that they would bring a title.
Yeah.
And again, extend the feud out. The Pumps will have more matches in the rematch with the Revival, which would be great.
I think the Revival will win.
Okay.
Only because I think they'll want to squeeze a bit more life out of this.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Because the feud has so much potential given the wrestling ability of both teams.
Yeah, that's true.
So, I would love American Alpha to win because, I'm such a big fan. But I think the Revival will win.
Yeah. I'll stick with American Alpha for now.
Okay.
But you could easily be right. It could go either way.
I think it could. I mean, I think that's what's so good about this card as well.
Yeah, definitely.
The takeover card. You know, every match is pretty much up in the air because you just can't predict who's going to win.
Exactly.
And I think that is testament to just how good NXT is and how good the writing is and how good the build-up has been.
Yeah, definitely.
We'll make note of these predictions and we'll revisit them on the next episode of our podcast.
Yep, that's what I'm doing now, in fact. No,
are you writing them down as we speak?
Yeah, it's fine.
Right, okay, fair enough.
Google document.
The next match is one that has sort of just been put together. I think it came together off the back of last week's NXT.
Oh, yeah.
So it's Apollo Crews versus Elias Samson, the Drifter.
Great. It's probably the least exciting match on the card, I'd say.
Yeah, I think so. I think it's just to pad the card out a little bit. Because, I mean, the potential to have incredible match after incredible match is unreal on this card.
Definitely.
But, I mean, I don't think this will be bad.
No. Apollo Crews is great. Just amazing what he can do with a guy his size.
Seriously impressive athlete. Unbelievable.
Yeah. Ridiculous. Elias Samson, hasn't really had any matches that last longer than like 5 minutes.
No.
Hasn't really done much of anything. I like his look. I like his entrance music, but that's about it.
The crowd just don't seem into it.
They don't at all.
And that's the big problem. I mean, he came in. I mean, there was a few vignettes that sort of came out for him.
I mean, nothing.
Just him sitting on train tracks, playing his guitar. Oh, no, he was singing, wasn't he?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he was singing, like, what, sort of on train tracks. And
What you need is what I am, or something like that.
Yeah. So a couple of strange vignettes that didn't really capture the imagination, because nobody was really that excited for him to debut. I wasn't. I was curious more than excited.
Yeah.
But, I mean, he came in, he's had a few squash matches. I believe he lost to Johnny Gargano on NXT last week.
Yep, he did that, and then he got beat him up afterwards.
Yeah, then he attacked him after the match. So he's had a few squash matches, then lost to Gargano, who I'm a big fan of as well. Mm-hmm. Johnny Wrestling.
Yeah, he's great.
Really, really good.
So good.
I hope he sticks around in NXT as well, because I know he's still doing indies, like a lot of the guys probably are. But
yeah, I think he's like contracted with WWE and things, but I hope he sticks around.
Yeah, I like him. He's cool. He's over as well.
Yeah, super over.
And then Apollo Crews came down to make the save.
Yeah.
Okay, which I didn't really understand, because Apollo Crews has been fairly quiet recently. He lost to Finn Balor a couple of weeks back on NXT in sort of their rematch, because Crews wanted to prove himself or whatever.
Yeah, that's a good match, though.
Yeah, it was a really good match.
Yeah.
But Crews has been really quiet since he fought for the NXT Championship, didn't he? But lost, obviously.
Yeah.
And then he's been fairly quiet since then. So it's good to see him come back and be in a feud again.
Definitely.
That's really all I've got to say about the match. I don't think it's going to be a classic.
No.
But I don't think it's going to be bad at the same time.
No, it'll be fine. It'll serve its purpose, I'm sure.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, so who do you think wins out of Apollo Crews and Elias Samson?
It's hard to say, again. I'm sure they want Elias Samson to go over as a bad guy and get, like, extra heat instead of we don't care heat. So I think probably Elias Samson, possibly by shenanigans. But yeah, it's hard to say, really.
Yeah, I agree. Apollo Crews probably needs a bit of momentum back in his run, because he hasn't won for a little while. So
that's very true, actually, yeah.
But I agree with what you say as well, because I think they want some real heat on Elias Samson, and not just the
go-away heat.
This guy's padding out the card.
Yeah.
Can we just get somebody better heat?
Exactly.
So it's a tough one. I'm going to go with Apollo Crews.
Okay.
The reason I'm going to go with Apollo Crews is because I think they may realise that Elias Samson isn't getting over and that they need their... Because I think Apollo is going to be a top face going forward.
Yeah, definitely.
And I think they'll want their top face to look strong.
Yeah, that's true.
But, I mean, it could go either way, but I'm going to say Apollo Crews.
Okay.
The next match I am beyond excited for. I'm so excited for this. And I think most of wrestling fans everywhere are excited for it.
Yeah.
So Sami Zayn is going to have his swan song in NXT, and he's going to fight Shinsuke Nakamura.
Yeah. That's going to be amazing.
It has the potential to be not only match of the night, but match of the weekend.
Yeah, definitely. Match of the year.
So this match has come about. Sami Zayn was in like a little series of number one contender matches with Samoa Joe.
Mm-hmm.
Samoa Joe eventually won said match, said series.
Yep.
And
Iron Man match.
Is fighting for the NXT Championship at the top of the card. Sami Zayn came down last week on NXT. Was it last week or the week before?
I think week before.
Week before. So a couple of weeks back, Sami Zayn came down on NXT. Said that, you know, fair enough, he lost against Samoa Joe, but, you know, he still feels that he deserves a place on the TakeOver card.
Yeah.
Cue William Regal.
Mm-hmm.
Says, well, you're in luck. You're going to fight this man. Okay, so cut to the video screen and a very fuzzy video of Nakamura sort of saying, NXT, Sami Zayn, I'll see you in Dallas.
Basically.
And that was that match sort of made.
Yeah, and the crowd goes nuts.
The crowd went ballistic. I mean, and that is all that match took to get over straight away.
Absolutely. People love Nakamura. Honestly, I don't follow Japanese wrestling. I hadn't heard him beforehand. I have seen a few of his matches since, and yeah, big fan now.
Yeah.
He's amazing.
He just, I remember watching Wrestle Kingdom 10 or Wrestle Kingdom 9. I can't remember which. And I saw him and I was like, man, these are the cards. I'd love to see like this guy make the transition to WWE, but I can't ever see it.
No.
And then when they sort of, all them rumors came out of Nakamura and the two Bullet Club guys, you know, coming over, and AJ Styles, of course.
Yeah.
It was like, holy crap, this is actually going to happen.
Yeah, crazy.
But I mean, the potential for these matches for Shinsuke going forward is just, it's crazy.
Mind-blowing, yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, this match, it doesn't really need any sort of build-up from us. It doesn't need any build-up from WWE. It's just going to be...
Yeah, just 18 names on a card by themselves is enough to sell the entire event.
Yeah, I think it is. I mean, people are just so excited for it.
Yeah.
Sammy obviously is on the main roster now.
Yep.
And obviously he's fighting for the IC title at WrestleMania.
Good busy weekend for Sammy.
Very busy. Massive weekend. He definitely deserves it.
Absolutely, yeah.
I think Nakamura wins.
Yeah, I agree.
Then they give Sami Zayn like a hero send off from NXT.
Yeah.
And then obviously he goes on to WrestleMania and does whatever he does there.
Yeah.
But that's gonna be an amazing match.
Yes, amazing.
And I hope WWE bring Nakamura t-shirts out soon.
Yeah.
I want a King of Strong Style t-shirt.
Definitely.
But yeah, I can't wait for that.
Yep.
Doesn't need any more build up. Are we both going for Nakamura there?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
It makes sense. It's got the guy leaving to put over the new guy.
Sure.
So.
Okay, so the NXT Women's Championship.
Mm-hmm.
Bayley versus Asuka.
That's another one. Amazing.
Again, this has incredible potential.
Yeah. I love both women. Mm. Both incredible wrestlers.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, what can we say? It's another dream match.
How did this come about? I mean, I know obviously Bayley is the champion. She was sort of not really doing much. She was in that feud with Nia Jax and Eva Marie.
Oh, yeah. That kind of went nowhere.
I think WWE maybe realised that that didn't have a lot of potential and maybe never wanted to see it. I thought Nia Jax versus Bayley at TakeOver London was great.
Yeah, it's fine, yeah. It was great. Made Nia look good and made Bayley look even better.
Told a great story.
Yep, it did.
The stuff with Eva Marie doesn't really work for me.
No. He just I don't know. I don't know what it is about Eva Marie. I just don't like her. as a performer, I just find this person just... It bores me.
The problem with Eva is that she's had such a bad reputation before she went and did some training and then came back.
Yeah.
And now she's back and the fans, all they want to do is destroy her.
Yeah.
All they want to do is boo her out of the building.
Yeah. But to be fair, even after her training, she's still not great. She's better, but she's still very slow, still very, I don't know.
But you can tell boring. WWE are desperate for Eva to get over. But I mean, we will touch on that in a bit because, I mean, there's more of Eva Marie to come, believe me. I think Asuka possibly helped Bayley.
I think she came down and... Oh, that's right. This first after a match with Carmella, which is another great match.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Eva Marie and Nia Jax came down to beat up Carmella.
Yeah.
And then Asuka came down and helped.
Yeah. And then they had like a tag match.
I think so, yeah. They had a tag match.
Yeah, they had a tag, yeah.
And that was really good.
And then William Regal came down and basically just announced Asuka as the number one contender.
Yep, that sounds about right.
To much excitement from the crowd again.
Yep.
Because again, I mean, the guys at Full Sail, they're smart fans.
Yeah, they're definitely smart indie bands.
They're not sort of casual wrestling fans. They know what's going to be good and what isn't going to be good.
Yeah.
This is going to be good, I think.
Definitely.
This is hard to call again.
Yeah. Another one is, I'm hoping that Bayley comes up to the main roster after WrestleMania.
Mm-hmm.
So that made me think Asuka's going to win.
Okay.
So I think that's what I'm going to go with for my prediction.
I would like Asuka to win, but I think Bayley may win.
Okay.
Because Bayley's got a lot of sort of momentum at the minute.
She does.
You know, she is like the face of the women's division in NXT.
Very true.
But I think Asuka's ready to sort of take that, you know, title from her,
mm-hmm.
and carry the brand forward. Because, yep. I mean, they will. There'll be a rematch.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
I'm
sure she will be champion at some point if she doesn't win this week.
Oh, for sure. So, I mean, if they don't... I mean, if Asuka wins, they still get a rematch at the next TakeOver or whatever. But if Bayley wins this time,
mm-hmm.
just carries it a little bit more. Maybe... I mean, how long she had that belt now?
A good while.
Yeah?
I think she won it at the first Sasha versus Bayley match.
Is that Brooklyn?
I think Brooklyn, yeah. That sounds right. Then they had the Iron Man match, Iron Woman match, at the one afterwards, which was London? No.
No. So I think we've got that wrong. I think the Iron Woman match was at Brooklyn.
Yeah.
And Bayley won it the one before.
Yeah, that sounds right.
Yeah.
Okay.
That sounds right. Okay, we'll go with that. So Bayley has had it for a little while, though.
Oh, yeah, she's had it for a good while. So, yeah, I really hope she gets to the main roster, especially with the other three NXT women. Being on the main roster.
The four horsewomen.
Yep, them. I think Asuka.
Okay. I'm going to go with Bayley, just because I think there's life in Bayley and NXT for now.
Okay. I don't disagree.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
That's going to be really good, I think.
Yep.
The potential to be a really good women's wrestling match. What's Definitely. Good about the NXT matches, especially like the events, the matches are given time to breathe and grow into sort of really good matches. They're not sort of, right, you've got 10 minutes, just go out there and sort of do whatever.
Do what you can. And
do what you can in with, you know, 10 minutes, that includes your entrance. So go out there and do what you can in with the time constraints.
Yes, we need to make room for the main event, which nobody cares about. Roman Reigns.
Yeah. I mean, in this case, the main event... is a match that I do care about.
Yeah, absolutely.
Finn Balor, who is the current NXT Heavyweight Champion,
mm-hmm.
against Samoa Joe.
Samoa Joe. Two excellent wrestlers again.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean, this has been building up for a little while. Finn's had a little bit of a quiet run fairly recently since... I mean, he defended the title at NXT TakeOver London.
He did.
Against Samoa Joe again, which was... outstanding.
Excellent match. Yeah. So good.
So, so good. But he's been pretty quiet since then.
Yeah, I think he's actually...
I mean, that was just before Christmas, wasn't it, London?
Yeah, pretty much. So, got a few months now.
Yeah. So, I mean, Finn's sort of not been doing much. I mean, he had a match on this week's NXT,
mm-hmm.
Which he won.
Yep.
I can't remember who he fought. If you can remember, please do refresh my memory.
Someone...
Good. Someone. He fought someone on NXT this past week.
I think it's just someone you don't really see very often. So I can't remember his name.
He didn't fight Rich Swann, did he, on this week's NXT?
Yeah, that was it. Rich Swann. He's really good. How long did he get that? He's really so good. Yeah. Oh, man. Okay. Sorry about forgetting that because I do really like Rich Swann.
I really like Rich Swann. He's a serious athlete as
he's
well.
He's really crazy.
Yeah. Like, he's doing them like the flips on his back.
Yeah.
Like the nip ups and like they're doing it, but he's not just like four in a row. It's like, Jesus, how is he doing this?
Crazy man.
Yeah, he's awesome. So sorry for forgetting that Rich won for Finn Balor. It was a great match.
Yeah, so good.
Really, really good.
More, please.
Yeah, absolutely more. And Samoa Joe has sort of been, he's been booked to look like an absolute monster.
Yeah.
since Takeover London. And I think that's the sign that they're going to put the belt on him.
Yeah, because there's been rumors for a while now that Balor's going to move up to the main roster.
Yeah.
He keeps teasing it on Twitter.
He does.
Like a master troll. And he is.
I don't know if you saw, but I know Carl Anderson is now at the Performance Center.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Obviously, Carl Anderson is one of the Bullet Club members who tags with Doc Gallows.
Yep.
Doc Gallows hasn't been sort of seen at the Performance Center yet. I don't know if he's checked into it or not, but he has been in WWE before as Festus, which was appalling.
Appalling.
And as Luke Gallows, who was in CM Punk's Straight Edge Society.
Much better.
So, I mean, much, much better. So, Doc Gallows sort of knows the score anyway and is probably ready for a step up to the main roster straight away.
Yeah, I'd love to.
And I'm sure Anderson is as well. But, so going back to the match, Samoa Joe's earned his title match by fighting with Sami Zayn over a few weeks.
Yep, yep.
They had a match which ended pretty screwy.
Yeah, it was like a double pin.
Double pin, yeah.
Didn't know who won, and they had like was it an Iron Man match or a 2 out of 3 falls match? I think it's 2 out of 3 falls.
Yeah, the 2 out of 3 falls match, yeah.
Yeah, it was like the entire episode of NXT, which is great.
Yeah, really good.
Which Joe won. Top. Yep. Yeah. And yeah, that's how that happened.
Yeah, so Samoa Joe is going to go into this match against Finn Balor with momentum very firmly on his side.
Yep, definitely.
I think Samoa Joe is going to win.
Yeah.
Because I think Finn Balor is going to move up to the main roster very, very soon.
I agree.
Because it just seems like a bit of a coincidence that Carl Anderson has checked into the Performance Center right before WrestleMania.
Yeah.
Finn Balor's got a title match right before WrestleMania.
Yeah, we've seen this before.
We have seen this pattern before, so...
Kevin Owens, stuff like that.
Yeah. I think Samoa Joe will win. Yeah. That's my prediction for that one.
Mine too.
Yeah, and then think Finn is going to move up to the main roster in the next few days, maybe. Yeah,
probably the Monday Raw after Mania.
I have a different theory, but I will go into this in a little while.
Okay, fair enough.
Okay.
Ooh, teasing it.
Yeah.
I like it.
So that's the NXT event that's coming up on Friday. NXT Takeover Dallas. It's 3 a.m. UK time. So I'm not sure if I'll watch it live or whether I'll catch it on Saturday morning, but either way. And obviously, we'll talk about it in more depth on the next show, with the results, go over our predictions and things like that.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, so this is going to be a long podcast today, so you're probably going to be you're in it for the in the long haul.
Yeah.
So Saturday is the WWE Hall of Fame ceremony.
Oh yes.
Okay, so let's have a quick look at the people to be inducted this year. We'll go from bottom to top.
Okay, sounds good.
So, we'll start with the celebrity wing.
Yeah.
And Snoop Dogg is being inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame celebrity wing.
Yay, I guess. weird choice.
Yeah. He's been on WWE programming a handful of times. Here are the reasons. I've got a little list here.
Okay.
So, Snoop Dogg once hosted an episode of Raw as a special guest.
Remember that was a thing? That was awful.
Yeah, there was some cool... when it first started, it was good.
Yeah.
Then they just sort of ran out of cool people to do it.
That's true, yeah.
He was the MC, Master of Ceremonies, for the Playboy Bunny Mania Lumberjill match at WrestleMania 24.
Oh, God. The less said about that, the better.
He's been on sort of Raw a few times since. That's fine. I mean, yeah. I do like Snoop.
Yeah, it's fine. He's been entertaining. It's just... I don't know, the whole drug thing. Because they've got the very strict drug policy in WWE, so it's like weird that they have someone who's such an advocate of, like, I don't know.
Smoking weed.
Exactly.
Just come out and say it.
Yeah, smoking weed. Smoke weed every day and all that.
Yeah, so maybe they should get RVD to induct it.
Yeah, maybe. That'd be great. I'd love to see that.
Yeah, so Snoop Dogg's going into the celebrity wing of the Hall of Fame.
Yeah, that's
That's fine. I mean, it's the part of the Hall of Fame that I care least about.
Yeah, the whole celebrity wing thing is weird to me, but that's fine.
Yeah, I mean, there's people who have... There are celebrities that have had fairly memorable moments on WWE.
Sure.
So, like when Pete Rose went in, obviously you always remember him from when he had his sort of thing with Kane at the WrestleManias for a few years. You know, people like that I'm fine with. But Snoop, that's... done that much. He's just sort of turned up. Obviously, he's the cousin of Sasha Banks.
That's true.
I don't know. That's fine.
Yeah.
Calvin Brodus Jr. is Snoop Dogg's real name.
Great.
I've got that in brackets here next to Snoop Dogg.
Oh, interesting. Fun fact.
Fun fact. Fun Snoop Dogg fact for you. Joan London is going to be the recipient of the Warrior Award.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
I have a problem with this.
Mm.
Right.
I think I know where you're going with it.
When Ultimate Warrior did his Hall of Fame induction speech,
yeah,
he wanted to recognise the people backstage who never got any recognition for the work that they do.
Yeah.
So, you know, refs, guys in the truck, you know, putting the program together, yeah, you know, even the guys who saw the pyro out or whatever. He wanted those people to be recognised.
Yeah.
And he said there should be some sort of recognition for those at the Hall of Fame.
Definitely. And I agree.
I also agree. WWE has...
WWE don't agree.
WWE, they've WWE'd it. That's what they've done.
Yeah.
They're like, Ultimate Warrior passed away, so let's make an award in his name, but do the opposite of what he wanted to do with it.
Yeah.
So last year, Conor Mahalik went into the Hall of Fame.
Mm-hmm. Which is fine.
Which is fine. I mean, I haven't got a problem with them...
I have a problem with the award itself. It's just like the name of it.
Yeah.
It doesn't make sense because that's not what the Warrior Award was supposed to be. Yeah. Well, not what he wanted.
So have an award for people who have sort of made an impression on the WWE universe.
Yeah.
Because Conor did. His story was, you know, heartbreaking.
Yeah, definitely.
And very, very touching. You know, and I haven't got a problem with them recognizing people like that.
No.
Just call the award something else because that's not what the Ultimate Warrior wanted the award to be.
Exactly. That's why he wouldn't have minded. Yeah, he's always got nothing against all these like sick people, but
yeah,
it's just it's not what he said. So like changing, it's like changing what he said into something it wasn't.
Yeah,
which is what we're talking about. What we didn't like, basically, about it.
Yeah, I mean, so
nothing against the poor people receiving the awards.
No, of course. I mean, so Dana Warrior will come out and give this award.
Mm-hmm.
She'll say something about the Ultimate Warrior, I'm sure.
Yeah.
She'll cry.
Yep.
And then she'll give the award to the person who is in who is going to be the recipient of it. This year it's Joan London. I don't know much about Joan London. I'm not mm-hmm. going to sit here and pretend I do.
Yep. I know.
The little blurb I've got here is she is an award-winning journalist, a best-selling author, and a breast cancer survivor.
Right. Okay.
So more power to her.
Yeah. Great.
You know, great that she survived breast cancer.
Absolutely.
And, you know, if she's... I'm assuming maybe she's had something to do with this Susan G. Komen.
Possibly.
A sort of deal that they go with once a year. I don't know, but either way, they're recognising Joan for whatever reason.
Yeah.
That's okay, fine. And that's fine. Again, we don't have a problem with these people receiving the award. It's the way that it's still portrayed as the Warrior Award.
Yeah.
Okay. Moving on from the Warrior Award this whole episode turns into a Warrior Award bashing show. Stan the Lariat Hansen.
Okay.
Okay. One time AWA World Heavyweight Champion, one time NWA United States Heavyweight Champion.
Great.
He's going to be inducted by Vader.
Cool. That's great. Before my time, before our time, probably.
Yeah, absolutely.
To be honest, this is the first time I've heard of him.
Right now?
Yeah, pretty much right now.
Okay.
That's fine. I'm sure he deserves it. And he helped build the wrestling industry to what it is now. So
of course, anybody who's paved the way, and you know, anybody that WWE feels deserves this award clearly does deserve it.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't know an awful lot about Stan Hansen. The name I've heard before.
It rings a bell, yeah.
I believe JR's probably said it in commentary. And when he said it, I've gone onto the internet to do some research or whatever. But he had one hell of a clothesline on him, apparently.
Great. So JBL loves him.
Yeah, JBL loves him. It's probably where JBL will probably claim that that's where he learned the clothesline from.
Probably.
He may very well have been. He may have been some sort of clothesline pioneer.
Maybe. Who knows?
That's cool. So Stan Hansen is going into the Hall of Fame.
Cool.
And he's been inducted by Vader. I'm sure there must be a connection there.
Yeah.
It seemed odd to me.
Maybe
I don't know the connection. I'm not sure. Yeah. But so Stan Hansen's going in.
Cool.
The next one is one that it's a more of a modern one.
Okay.
So Jacqueline.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Miss Jackie to some, I'm not sure. But two-time WWF Women's Champion, one-time WWE Cruiserweight Champion.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
Jackie had a great career.
Yeah, she did.
Real good. I believe she was in WCW at one point.
Yep, I don't remember, but I'm sure.
and obviously, I remember her best from her time, sort of late 90s, you know, when she was feuding with Sable and revealing more skin on TV than I'm sure she cares to mention these days.
Yeah.
Maybe, but... And the Dudley Boys are inducting Jacqueline.
Cool, okay. I like Jacqueline. She's one of the, you know, good female wrestlers from that time.
Very good female wrestler, yeah.
Great.
Good one of the actual wrestlers from that period as well.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. A lot,
at the time, you know, the nudity aspect was starting to be brought onto WWF at that point TV.
Yeah.
Jacqueline still sort of, although she did sort of partake in that side of things, she was still a very good wrestler.
Yeah, definitely.
So I can see why she'd be inducted into the Hall of Fame.
Yeah, absolutely.
Is Sable in the Hall of Fame?
That's a good question. I don't know. I'll do some research right now.
Yeah. Just a little side note there. But, I mean, Jacqueline fully deserves to go in.
Yep.
The younger generation probably don't know who Jacqueline is. Saying that, the younger generation probably don't know who any of these people are.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Unless they've done their extensive research on them since they were announced. But, yeah. Go back, check out some matches from Jacqueline's career.
Mm-hmm.
And you can watch her go and get put through a table by the Dudley Boys as well.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm assuming that's why they are inducting her.
Yeah, probably makes sense. Apparently, Sable is not in the Hall of Fame just yet.
That's an interesting one.
Hmm.
Because Sable was... I don't think she... Not as far as I'm aware. I don't think she has heat with WWE.
Don't think so.
I know that she's married to Brock Lesnar.
Yep.
She was a big... She was a big deal.
Yeah, she was. I'm sure she'll be in eventually.
I'm sure she will. I mean, she obviously did the Playboy thing for WWE. When, you know, Divas were doing that.
Yep, yep.
I was always a big Sable fan. She's in the same mold for me as sort of Trish Stratus.
Yeah, that's fair.
Sable came in. She was just a valet for Marvelous Mark Marrow.
Yeah.
Good God. But then she really came into her own, started taking the wrestling aspect of things very serious and had some really great matches.
Yeah.
Again, with the likes of Jacqueline. So I expect Sable will go in at some point.
Yeah, I'm sure.
But this year, Jacqueline's going in.
Yep, that's fair. She deserves it.
Yeah, absolutely. 100%. Who else we got? Right, so the Big Boss Man.
Great.
Always been a really big Boss Man fan.
Yeah, he's solid. Again, solid wrestler. A lot of good matches back in the day.
Yeah.
And I liked him a lot as well.
When I first started watching wrestling back sort of the turn of the 80s into the 90s, because I'm old, the Big Boss Man was sort of a massive, you know, character at that point.
Yeah.
Obviously, we're in an era where everybody portrayed a character.
Yeah, definitely.
Everybody was something.
Yeah.
But the Boss Man was legit.
Yeah.
Like, he was a corrections officer. So obviously WWF brought him in, or WWE brought him in, then it was WWF, you know, and he had the cop gimmick going on.
Yeah.
Big tough guy, great entrance music.
Yeah.
That is never on any of the WWE games now.
No, it's a shame.
They always go for the music when he was in the tag team.
Oh, yeah.
With Akeem.
Sure, sounds right.
Do you want to research that for me?
Just sure.
Okay, so I sound like a complete idiot. So the Big Boss Man was always a favourite of mine.
Yep.
I think my favourite Boss Man match was when SummerSlam 91, when he fought the Mountie in a match where the loser would go to jail.
Oh, right, okay.
Which led to a brilliant... A brilliant follow-up where the Mountie was getting arrested and all that sort of stuff.
Oh, yeah, I haven't seen it.
Yeah, Mountie gave the middle finger to the police officers taking his finger. He was taking his fingerprints. It was brilliant. But that's a Boss Man memory for me.
Yeah.
Yeah. He had the appalling Kennel from Hell match with Al Snow.
Yeah.
If you don't know what the Kennel from Hell is, it was like a Hell in a Cell with dogs in between that. And then a cage separating the wrestlers and the dogs.
Yeah, it was terrible. Don't work with animals.
Don't work with animals.
It's just not in wrestling.
It was Akeem and the Big Boss Man who had a tag team. I just couldn't remember the name of them, and it was the Twin Towers.
Oh, yeah. That's
Akeem was like playing an African man.
Oh, God, yeah.
But Akeem was actually white.
Yeah.
No, had never, probably couldn't even find Africa on a map. So,
weird gimmick.
Very strange. But Slick, the Doctor of Style Slick, is inducting the Big Boss Man into the Hall of Fame.
Okay.
So the Boss Man definitely deserves to go in.
Yep.
Both runs in WWE had were fantastic.
Yep.
Great character. So very well deserved.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Okay, so next in is the Fabulous Freebirds.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so if you don't know who the Fabulous Freebirds are, that's Michael Hayes, Terry Gordy, Buddy Rogers, and Jimmy Garvin. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
The Fabulous Freebirds, very flamboyant sort of team. You may have heard them sort of mentioned on WWE TV fairly recently because of the way that New Day defends the tag team championships.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
The Freebirds made that rule up, okay, and they called it the Freebird rule. Okay. Yeah, so, I mean, the New Day are actually inducting the Freebirds into the Hall of Fame.
I didn't know that. That's awesome.
Yeah. obviously, sort of, because they adopt this Freebird rule.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm sure WWE have seen something in that, and they've decided to go with that. But that's cool. So, the Freebirds, very flamboyant team, stable, whatever you want to call them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, go check the videos out, because their hair is unbelievable, all of them.
Yeah, it's fabulous.
It's fabulous, yeah. Nice. Michael PSA's I've got a lot of time for.
Yeah, he's still backstage stuff these days.
Yep, still dressing very sharp.
Yep.
Still very flamboyant, even now. The Fabulous Freebirds, without question, deserve to go into the Hall of Fame.
Fun fact, do you know what the PS stands for, Michael PSA's?
No, please tell me.
Stands for Purely Sexy.
Are you serious?
Yeah, that's what I've got on here, Wikipedia.
All right, excellent, fair enough. So the little bit of blurb I've got here. Gordy and Roberts, so Terry Gordy and Buddy Roberts are going to be inducted, you know, posthumously. Is that how you spell it? How you pronounce it?
Sure.
Yeah, because obviously they aren't with us anymore, unfortunately. Yeah.
Have you heard this out loud before?
They are... No, I don't think I've ever said it out loud. two-time WCW World Tag Team Champions, two-time WCW US Tag Team Champions, one-time WCW Six-Man Tag Team Champions.
God, remember that was a thing?
Which is something that sounds very interesting indeed.
Yeah.
And, yeah, credited for creating the Freebird rule.
Yeah.
Whereas any member of a tag team could defend the tag team titles.
Yep, makes sense.
So, yeah, the Freebirds. Go check out some highlights of the Freebirds. Just go and see... you know, how they carried themselves, what their look was like.
Look at their hair.
Very cool.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so The Godfather.
Yes.
How do you feel about The Godfather going into the Hall of Fame?
Yeah, legend, obviously. He was around when I started watching, still.
Sure.
And then he became The Good Father when he joined the...
Right to Censor.
Right to Censor, that's it, RTC. Which is a fun gimmick. Even though a lot of people don't seem to like it these days, I thought it was cool at the time.
What, Right to Censor?
Yeah.
Yeah, I liked it.
It made sense because, like, making fun of, like, censors, TV censors.
Incredible heels as well, Right to Censor.
Yeah. I thought they're great.
Yeah. Stephen Richards.
Yeah, Stephen Richards.
Mr. Venus.
Yeah, I thought it was great.
Yeah, absolutely. When I first started watching wrestling, Charles Wright, who plays The Godfather, was Papa Shango.
Oh, yeah.
And I've sort of seen him go through gimmicks. You know, he was Papa Shango, obviously, when I first started watching it. Then he was Karma Mustafa in the Nation of Domination in the late 90s.
That was cool, actually.
And then, obviously, people probably know him most for being the Godfather.
Yeah, I think so.
I've always been a big fan of him. I always think he's a great worker.
Yeah, entertaining.
Massive guy.
Yeah.
Real big guy.
Huge.
Delivers a serious shoulder breaker.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Nice. That was his finishing move, I think, when he was the Godfather. When he was, sorry, Papa Shango.
Cool.
And when he was Karma.
Cool, okay. I'll take it with it. I don't remember.
WWE 2K16 should confirm this for you, because I think Karma is on it.
Oh, yeah, he is, yeah. I'll check it out.
Then he did a Death Valley Driver when he was the Godfather.
Cool.
Which was eloquently named the Pimp Drop.
Oh, yeah. I remember that.
The little blurb I've got here, one-time WWF Intercontinental Champion, one-time WWF Tag Team Champion.
Cool.
I think that was with D'Lo Brown.
All right, yeah, sure.
Because they fought the Big Boss Man and Bull Buchanan at WrestleMania 2000, right, in the opening match. I can't remember if it was for the titles or not, but I do think that's who the Godfather was Tag Team Champion with.
Cool, okay.
I like the Godfather, he's cool.
Yeah, great.
He's being inducted by the APA.
Makes sense.
So JBL and Ron Simmons.
Okay. Great.
Very good.
Yeah, deserves it.
Yeah. Again, guys, if you are sort of a new-ish fan and you aren't aware of, you know, some of the guys that we're talking about, you don't know who they are or whatever, you know, go check them out because they've given so many great memories, especially for fans like me over the years. And it's cool to see these guys sort of be inducted into the Hall of Fame.
Yeah, definitely.
The big one and the main inductee this year, the headline inductee is Sting.
Yes, definitely. Obviously, huge WCW legend. Hadn't had much present in WWE until recently. But done a lot for the industry.
Oh, my God.
Complete some amazing matches over the years. Just, yeah, amazing, incredible. He definitely deserves it more than anyone.
I think Sting's one of my sort of favorite wrestlers and characters of all time.
Yeah, probably.
He took, I mean, obviously when he first started out, he was sort of, he was a tag team with the Dingo Warrior.
Oh, yeah.
Who later became the Ultimate Warrior.
Cool.
And they had the spiky bleached blonde hair with a little ponytail at the back.
Yeah.
I remember when I was young, I was bought some wrestling figures by my parents. And they brought me the WCW figures were so strange because they were just like, they were stiff in one pose.
Oh, right.
And I have a Sting action figure. I think my nephew still has, I'm not sure if it was mine or someone else's Sting action figure from WCW.
Nice.
And his hands were above his head and he was smiling. It was so hard to have a wrestling match with this character. But so that's when I first started, really got introduced to Sting. But then, you know, amazing sort of career as the good guy, bleached blonde hair, smiling, colourful face paint sort of thing.
Yeah.
And then to make the transition to sort of the Crow Sting that people will know him for now, it's just something that, it just took the character of Sting and reinvented it.
Yeah, definitely.
And that's so difficult to sort of maintain that level of popularity and do something completely different.
Yeah.
And I don't know, Sting's just so cool.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's a great transformation, great look, great evolution of his character. It's just, yeah.
Just a great worker. I mean, even amazing. Sort of when he was in TNA, he had great matches in TNA. I've had the pleasure of seeing Sting wrestle live
nice.
A couple of times. You know, it was awesome when he first came into WWE, and it was just great to see him on there.
Yeah.
I mean, I know he lost to Triple H.
Yeah, he should have won.
Yeah, I mean, he shouldn't have lost.
Yeah, that was the...
No.
Triple H.
Yeah, but, I mean...
Triple H being Triple H.
You know, here, I mean, it speaks for itself. Six-time WCW World Heavyweight Champion, two-time NWA World Heavyweight Champion, two-time WCW United States Heavyweight Champion, three-time WCW World Tag Team Champion.
Cool.
Was in a great tag team with Lex Luger.
Yeah.
As well, back in the day. Cool. Ric Flair's inducting him.
Makes sense.
It seems fitting. They had the last ever match on Nitro together.
Yeah, great feuds.
Over the years, great feuds. It just seems fitting. Sting is outstanding. Is one of, you know, you don't get wrestlers like Sting anymore.
No. It's something else. Once in a lifetime kind of
just performance. An incredible performer.
Yeah.
And fully, fully deserving of the induction into the WWE Hall of Fame.
Absolutely.
Yeah, just amazing. So that is the end of the that sort of that's the WWE Hall of Fame ceremony for 2016.
Yep.
Okay. Then of course Sunday is the big show. No pun intended. but before we sort of go into that, let's talk about what happened on Raw this week.
Yes. Now,
as we said in episode 7 of the Sonny and Finn show, which you can go and check out now.
Yep, SoundCloud and YouTube.
Yep.
And iTunes and everywhere else.
And Stitcher.
Yep.
we sort of said that the build-up hadn't been very good to WrestleMania.
Yeah, I agree.
This week's Raw didn't really do anything to change our opinion on that.
Yeah, sadly.
Unfortunately. But it did give a few talking points.
Yeah.
So the opening of Raw this week was The Undertaker sort of saying again that the blood of Shane McMahon will be on his hands, on Vince's hands and not his, but that Vince's blood may be on The Undertaker's hands.
Yep, which, kind of didn't make much sense because it's kind of working for him, trying to defeat Shane, but I don't know.
Yeah.
It's fine. It was a really good promo, actually. I liked it a lot.
Yeah, it was. I mean, the opening segment was really good.
Yeah, really good.
Shane McMahon comes down.
Mm-hmm.
Interrupts The Undertaker. Acts like a serious badass, to be fair. You know, they've made Shane look real good going into this match.
Yeah, definitely.
So Shane walks down the ramp to confront The Undertaker. Undertaker says that Shane, since birth, has been Vince's bitch.
All right. If you say so.
Yeah. And then Shane goes crazy. Starts punching The Undertaker with his crazy, fists, real fast fists and all that sort of stuff. Yeah. And it was pretty cool. And then they start brawling on the outside of the ring. Undertaker starts throwing the Shane McMahon around.
Mm-hmm.
And then, I mean, bear in mind, this is the first bit of Raw. Undertaker starts tearing the announce table apart.
Yeah.
And all that sort of stuff. And I sort of saw this coming when Undertaker did it. Mm. You know, Shane gets the monitor, hits Undertaker around the head, and then goes for a leap of faith.
Yeah. Crazy elbow drop.
Yeah.
Off the ring. Corner of the ring. Don't know how he does that. Defies gravity somehow. Magic.
It shows that he still has it.
Absolutely. Yeah, he looks great as well.
He's ripped.
He's super ripped. Great abs.
Like, because he lifted his shirt up to wipe his head.
Yeah.
And I was like, Jesus Christ, Shane is absolutely ripped.
It's ridiculous.
Because you never see Shane with his top off.
No.
Shane's cut up.
He is.
He
just lose that shirt for the match.
Yeah.
Show what you got.
Yeah. Show it off. If I had that body, I'd be like, I'd probably go to work with no top off.
Yeah, same here. Hello, ladies.
Yeah. Oh, let me just pick this pencil up. But yeah, so Shane's ripped, and I think that match, that's the match I think I'm most hyped up for.
Yeah, me too. Definitely the biggest match with the most biggest implications.
Yeah.
I know I said last week that I thought Undertaker might win. I think I'll change my mind. I think Shane's going to win.
Fair enough.
Because it makes sense. I think Undertaker will have another match, just but not at Mania, but like SummerSlam or something.
Yeah. Trying to think what else happened on Raw this week. Oh, Chris Jericho, surprise, surprise, accepted AJ Styles' challenge.
Shock. To be honest, I thought he'd already accepted it. We started talking about it, I was like, oh wait, didn't you already accept it now?
Yeah. I mean, we knew it was always going to happen.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't have all this build up for them to go, no, we're just not going to have it.
Yeah. This is a tough AJ Styles fight. He's late, wasn't he? Yeah. But no. Yeah.
Nothing really much else significant happened on Raw this week.
No. Well, after Chris Jericho did the whole thing, Zack Ryder, he had a match with Zack Ryder, and he won. Zack Ryder actually won a match on Raw somehow, by shenanigans.
By a schoolboy pin after distraction from AJ Styles.
Yep.
Who was stood ringside doing chants about Jericho.
Yeah, what was it? Y2 Jackass.
Y2 Jackass, yeah. He was wearing a baseball cap and no top. Figure.
Yeah.
But,
buy my hat, please.
Yeah, I've got a new hat out. I'm going to wear it, but I'm not going to wear the t-shirt to distract you from the hat. Zack Ryder won a match on Raw.
Great. Got instantly code-breakered for his trouble. Is that a thing? Code-breakered?
Code-breakered? Jericho delivered a code-breaker for Zack Ryder's trouble.
There you go. That sounds better. So instantly gets his heat back. Makes Zack Ryder look kind of weak in comparison, but whatever. It was fine. He won.
But Zack Ryder's won his match going into WrestleMania.
Yeah. Momentum.
Which is great. So, I mean, I've heard that Ryder's going to get a push. I don't know if this is going to sort of come to fruition or not, but I'm sure we'll see.
Use him. Might as well.
Yeah, sure. I like him. But at the same time, he's got the Hype Bros thing going on NXT with Mojo Rawley.
Yeah.
Who I cannot stand.
Me neither. It's like, if we could make someone the exact opposite of who I am, it would be Mojo Rawley. Yeah. It's just, but I don't think people really care about that tag team very much on NXT. I know I don't.
I definitely don't.
I doubt it would last very long, to be honest.
I don't think it'd last long on the main roster.
No.
I don't think people care about it all that much on NXT.
They don't know.
But, that's cool, but, so if Ryder gets a push, that's fine. I've got really no problem with it at all.
Yeah, I like Ryder.
Great look, good in-ring performer.
Yeah.
Good on the mic as well. There's probably not much more that you can ask of Zack Ryder.
Yeah, he's solid mid-carder.
Yeah, sure.
I think US champ, wasn't he?
US champ. He was before. During that time when Ryder was...
crazy popular.
Crazy popular.
Until Cena buried him a little bit.
Good, yeah.
Yeah, as
and
he
Kane.
Does. And Kane.
Yeah, that weird storyline with Kane.
Yeah. Like
but what else we got on Raw this week? Oh, yeah. They've the Divas tag team match.
Yep, that was the thing. Was that on here?
They've confirmed.
Oh, yeah. So it's going to be probably one of the worst tag team names ever. Team, was it Bad and Blonde?
Bad and Blonde, yeah.
Bad and Blonde versus Team Total Divas.
We'll run through the WrestleMania card in a little while. Basically, at the minute, we're just filling you in with what happened on Raw. Then we'll go into WrestleMania.
Yeah, so it was a match between Emma and Paige, which is a decent match. I think it's one of the decent matches.
On paper, that's a really good match.
Yeah. They had a great match in NXT. This was slightly less... I don't know if they had time to really explore.
I think you're right. I think it was this was a segue into the final hype for the Divas Tag Team match. Hype is the word you can use.
So yeah, after the match, everybody got involved and started beating each other up. Emma actually won, which is good. Then everybody came in the ring and attacked. Team Band and Blonde, like, getting up a hand because they're one woman up. And then the final person in the tag match came down. Who's it going to be? It's Eva Marie. God damn it.
To no reaction at all.
A huge boo from the negative reaction.
Yeah, negative reaction.
And apparently I heard afterwards that the guys in charge backstage were like expecting her to get cheered. And I just thought, why would you ever think that? Don't you watch NXT?
Yeah.
Why are you deaf? Do you not listen to the crowd?
Yeah. Do you not read the internet?
Yeah.
Like, just read the internet. Be,
It's like, the people who come to war live events aren't the same people who watch Total Divas. So, no. why would you expect anything less?
Yeah. So, Eva Marie came out to make the big save.
Yeah.
The other Divas acted,
standoffish.
Yeah, standoffish. To Eva Marie. I haven't watched this season of Total Divas, so I don't know what's sort of going on storyline-wise as far as that goes, but...
They brought in some new women. I don't understand why they do that. It's like... I've kind of figured it as a show that it's like behind the scenes of the Divas, so you know and love.
Yeah.
Here's this person you've never heard of before. Like, what?
I think she was in Tough Enough.
Oh, was she?
Yeah.
No, I think it was Tough Enough.
Oh, right. She was in Tough Enough. She didn't win it.
Oh.
She was... probably the most attractive woman in Tough Enough. Okay. Vince McMahon saw dollar signs.
Yeah. Jing.
And bikini pictures.
Yeah.
And she's now in Total Divas. But.
Good having Vince.
So yeah, so that's Eva Marie was the final piece of the Total Divas versus Bad and Blonde puzzle.
Blech.
Yeah.
What else happened? Charlotte versus defeated Becky Lynch. That was cool.
it didn't last very long though, I don't think.
No, quite a short match. Charlotte Banks was there. Did like a little stare off thing, I think.
Yeah. Did Becky win?
Nope, Charlotte won. Which is a shame because Sasha won her match on SmackDown the week before. And then you kind of think you give Becky Lynch a win as well to make her look on par, but.
Yeah, I think Ric Flair was saying, was calling Becky Lynch a crazy person after the match.
Yeah, I heard that. It's like,
what are you doing, you crazy person? Something like that.
Yeah.
Which I thought, that's fairly rich.
Yeah.
Thanks, Nature Boy.
Yeah. Oh, I also had Big Show and Kip. I think I skipped this match, but it was Big Show and Kane versus the Social Outcasts.
I skipped that as well. This was pushing the Andre the Giant Battle Royal.
Yeah.
So obviously what Raw was this week was final hype for WrestleMania.
Yeah, yeah.
Because they seemingly don't care at this point what happens on SmackDown. It has no bearing to what's going to happen on the pay-per-views, seemingly.
Pretty much.
We'll get to that in a minute because the SmackDown segment isn't going to be very long.
No.
So yeah, I mean, I did skip that as well because I had no interest in it at all.
Same.
Because I know that the Social Outcasts were sitting on the side of the ring like they always do, doing a bit of talking or whatever.
Yeah.
And then Big Show came down to no reaction. Then Kane came down to no reaction. And didn't this end in a massive brawl?
I think so. I think like the double choke slam on Mark Henry came down for some reason and they double choke slammed him. and then they chokeslammed all four members of the Social Outcast at once, and like, and that was pretty cool, I guess.
But I think more people came down. This is just to show that there is a battle royal on Sunday. Yeah. That's what happens. Every time there's a battle royal, everybody in it. Same with the Royal Rumble, like the final Raw before the Royal Rumble.
Yeah.
Right, quick, get everyone down to ringside and then have the favourite for the Royal Rumble, the biggest, strongest man, throw a load of people out and have him standing tall at the end.
Yeah, exactly.
So that's what this is. Were Kane and Big Show standing tall at the end of this?
They were.
Right. Okay. Obviously, that's teasing that one of them is going to win it.
Yep.
I don't think they will.
Nope.
But well, again, we'll get to that on our WrestleMania predictions. There is some more people added to that as well, but again, we'll talk about that in a little while.
Yeah.
There was a six-man... Was there a six-man tag team match, or was it just a normal tag team match?
It was six-man. It was Dolph Ziggler, Sami Zayn, and Sin Cara versus Kevin Owens, The Miz, and Stardust. It was the world's longest six-man tag team match in history. It went on forever.
Yeah, this was basically at the top of the third hour of Raw.
Yeah.
By this point, the crowd had been killed off. They'd had a very long authority segment.
Yeah,
it didn't need to go on for as long as it did. Obviously, Reigns interrupted that and got booed out of the building.
Yeah, Alex kept skipping forward ahead and said, nope, still talking, nope, still talking, nope, still going, oh, God, shut up, Triple H.
And by the end of that, the energy was sucked out of the room.
Yeah.
I mean, 3 hours is a long time anyway, but when you have to sit through boring crap segments like that with people that you don't really care about, I mean, people are still like Triple H, but nobody likes Roman Reigns.
Exactly.
And that's what the problem with this is.
Yeah.
Following on from that segment, there was like a backstage bit a bit later on in the show where the Dudleys lured Roman Reigns.
Oh, yeah.
Because I think something happened on SmackDown.
Yeah, I think Bubba Ray versus Roman Reigns had a match.
Great.
Yeah.
And then the Dudleys started beating him up, and then Triple H came out of nowhere. Then the Dudleys just walked off.
Yeah.
Great.
Okay.
So that's the hype for the championship match. I think there was a bit at the end as well, but
yeah, that was.
I felt bad for this six-man tag team match because the energy had been sucked out of the room. The crowd were chanting because they were bored, and it wasn't because the match was crap. It's because they were bored.
It's like half the million people in this match like haven't been around for all that much, and it's like no one cares. It's like Sin Cara and Stardust and
His interest is gone.
Yeah. Is that no one cares about these people? The only people they care about is Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens.
Yeah, they want to see Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn fight.
Yeah.
And, I mean, any reaction that match got was for the potential of them to come in face-to-face.
Exactly.
Team Sami Zayn won that match.
Mm-hmm.
And Sami Zayn pinned Kevin Owens.
Yep.
So the final hype for that going into that match is that, you know, Sami Zayn could win the championship.
Yep. Which would be great if he did.
Yeah, it'd be awesome if he did. Because there's a lot of weight for that. A lot of weight involved in that Sami Zayn, Kevin Owens feud, for sure. Yeah,
absolutely.
There was a Brock Lesnar and Dean Ambrose segment on Raw, I believe.
Oh, yeah. Heyman came down and did his little thing with a microphone.
Yeah.
Talking, that's what it's called.
Talking.
Yeah. I could listen to Heyman talk all day. He's great. Yeah,
he's excellent.
Dean Ambrose came down with like a big...
He came down with like a...
big trolley kind of thing.
Like a trolley, yeah.
Yeah. Picked up loaded weapons, had barbed wire, steel bat, chainsaw.
Yeah.
All sorts of things, and kind of walked off.
Didn't even acknowledge Brock and Heyman in the ring, did he?
Yeah, that's pretty great, actually.
I think Brock's having a lot of fun in WWE at the minute.
Yeah.
You know, he seems to sort of, you know, enjoy the things that Heyman says. You know, he calls him a lot of funny names and says funny things and stuff like that. And
funny.
That's
Heyman funny.
But so I mean there wasn't any hype for that match apart from that segment.
Yeah, but that's fine. It's gonna be a good match. People like that match either way.
Yeah, people like Dean Ambrose. People like Brock Lesnar. Crowd's gonna be mixed for that match.
Yeah.
So. That match has sort of had enough hype as it is.
Yeah, I think so.
I think they just can't wait for the two of them to fight.
Yeah.
But then we had the final segment of Raw, unless there was anything else.
Kalisto defeated Connor. So that's nice. From, you know, Connor put the attention.
Yeah.
This is it, remember who Connor is, because I didn't.
The roster must be really bad with injuries.
Yeah.
And so thin for them to have to wheel Connor out on Raw to have a singles match against Kalisto.
Yeah.
Did Ryback come down or something afterwards?
Yeah, Ryback came down afterwards and had to stay off. I'm a big guy. And yeah. Well, that's the.
Oh, God. Okay.
Did he buy it back?
Yeah. And then the final, the authority came out to finish what they started earlier on before Roman Reigns. And like when that segment was announced just before it happened, I was like, Jesus Christ, again. Like,
yeah. But they didn't talk enough.
No one cared for the first segment. And then you're going to come out and talk again.
Yeah.
But, you know, inevitably it ended with Roman Reigns coming down and there being a big fight.
Yeah.
And then loads of people came down.
Yeah, to break them all up.
Yeah. And then a load of people like sort of came down to break things up, and
you've seen this a lot of times before. It's
this was a very sort of WWE thing to do.
Yeah,
it was have a load of people fight, hype the match, like they really want to get at each other, but you know they can't because everyone's separating them.
Yeah,
and Triple H and they were all sort of stood outside the ring, and Roman Reigns did a massive dive.
Yeah, that was cool.
Which was cool. Everyone cheered for that. And then Roman Reigns got back in the ring, and then everyone started chanting, "You still suck." So,
poor Roman.
Poor Roman. I mean, so that was sort of the final hype for WrestleMania. It was not a great episode of Raw.
Yeah.
I mean, apart from the first two segments of Raw, the Shane and Undertaker part and the Y2J, AJ part, it was very much a... you could play with your phone during the whole episode of Raw and really miss nothing.
Yeah, pretty much. Big waste of like 2 hours.
You watch Raw in like an hour now.
Yeah, pretty much.
SmackDown this week added nothing. I mean, the SmackDown tapings were yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
So Tuesday night, today's Wednesday.
Mm-hmm.
Added nothing. There was 3 matches on the whole show.
Yeah, yeah.
You got that on there?
I've lost them, but they were on there.
Right, fair enough.
Even my laptop can't be interested because it just disappeared.
Yeah, so there was 3 matches on SmackDown this week. That's why I consider Raw the final hype for WrestleMania, because, you know, SmackDown offered pretty much nothing.
Yeah, oh, it is. Here it comes. Oh, yeah, so we had 3 whole matches. AJ Styles versus Heath Slater.
Which, of course.
Guess who won? Heath Slater, just kidding. AJ Styles won. Had Devon Dudley versus Jimmy Uso, for some reason. Devon won.
Clean, apparently, as well, with a spine buster of all things, so.
Weird.
I'm sure that was great.
Yeah. And then you had Dean Ambrose versus Eric Rowan, won the Wyatts, which is like the only one who wasn't injured somehow.
Yeah.
Dean won, obviously.
Yeah. And that's SmackDown, so. Was it? what SmackDown was filled with this week, we've no idea, because obviously it doesn't air until tomorrow in the States and adverts. Friday over here.
Yeah, lots of adverts.
They pad it out.
Why WrestleMania?
Yeah, WrestleMania is free if you are if you are a new subscriber and blah blah blah. There'll be a lot of that on SmackDown this week, and 3 matches. Mauro Ranallo is enough for you to tune into SmackDown and listen to his great commentary.
Yep, he needs to be on more.
He needs to be on Raw. He definitely needs to call pay-per-views. He's excellent. But SmackDown is very throwaway this week. If you're expecting some big angles going into WrestleMania, you're not going to get them, and you may as well avoid it.
Yeah, pretty much.
So that takes us to the big show. WrestleMania is such a big deal for wrestling fans all over the world. Regardless of whether you watch WWE or not, you always watch WrestleMania.
Mm-hmm.
Like everybody, like WrestleMania's crazy hype nowadays. It's like people, like bars have, late night showings on big screens of WrestleMania, and you can buy tickets to wrestling shows that have a wrestling show and then have a live screening of WrestleMania and stuff like that. It's crazy.
That's great.
I love WrestleMania. Finn loves WrestleMania. Me and my friends get together every single year, like I said on episode 7. Of our show. We get together every year and have done for as many years as I can remember.
Yeah.
It's always a good, fun night. It's exactly the same this year. It's going to be the first time that Finn is joining us.
Yay.
We will be doing our live WrestleMania predictions WWE 2K16 stream as well.
That'd be fun.
For YouTube, which should be great. All of our other pay-per-view streams have been brilliant.
Yeah.
So let's get into it. There's now 4 matches on the pre-show.
Mm-hmm.
So the pre-show starts at 10 p.m. UK time.
Well, we have to be awake.
Yep. So we're gonna do our stream probably around 8 o'clock.
Yeah, that sounds good.
So 8 PM. So we're going straight through. There's four matches on the pre-show now.
So we are like the pre-show.
So yeah, we are the pre-show. Yeah. Only you haven't got to put up with Booker T doing his five
taking his hand
thingy pose and rubbish catchphrases and stuff like that.
Shucky ducky. Quack quack.
Yeah. Exactly that. Instead, you get to watch us play WWE 2K16, do some swearing, and talk about wrestling.
Yeah,
it's a good time. So, yeah, like I said, four matches on the pre-show. The Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal.
Yes. Who's left who isn't injured at this point? We've got Big Show and Kane.
Have you got a list on there of who's in it?
I know that they have
added more people to it since Raw.
Yes, that's... Babe, just a second, I'll find it. Andre...
So the main people in it are, I mean, the ones that WWE are hyping are the Big Show, Kane, Mark Henry.
Mm-hmm. There we go. Okay, so here's what we know so far. We've got Curtis Axel, Adam Rowe, T. Slater, Bo Dallas from Social Outcasts, Kane and Big Show, Tyler Breeze, Damien Sandow was there. On Raw as well. Oh, really? That was a good 5 seconds. So he was on screen.
Good.
Goldust and R-Truth. Darren Young. Remember him? Drax Swagger. Mark Henry. Fandango. Connor and Victor. New Sensen. And that's it.
Is that 20 people? Or?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So there's four people missing.
So there's four people not announced yet.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't expect anybody to come back to be in the Andre the Giant Battle Royal.
No, although Cesaro apparently is, according to rumours, getting close to coming back. So possibly he could come back during the thing and win it, maybe.
Maybe they'll just have John Cena come down and win it.
Yeah, lol, Cena wins.
Yeah. I mean, the fact that I care very little about this, because after WrestleMania, it was seemingly sort of hardly ever mentioned again after maybe Raw the next night.
Yeah, pretty much.
You never see that trophy again.
Nope.
Again, apart from maybe on Raw the next night, depending on who wins it. I mean, if Cena comes down and wins it, then you'll see it every night until next year's WrestleMania.
Yeah, pretty much.
And he'll defend it then as well. And be in the main event. But I don't know. Who do you see winning this?
I honestly don't know. All those people... No one really stands out. Honestly, no idea. Time to do it again. Kane, maybe? I guess? He's not done anything much recently.
Well, I'm going to go with Mark Henry.
Okay.
That's my pick.
Good pick.
The world's strongest man. Sort of.
I'll go with Tyler Breeze because I like Tyler Breeze. He deserves better.
Well, your prediction isn't coming in. That's good.
Nope. Or Damon Sandow. One of those.
That'd be awesome.
It would be.
But I see Mark Henry, Kane or Big Show winning it.
Yeah, probably.
Maybe they'll have Big Show win it and it'll be like, oh, the first ever two-time winner of the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal.
Then he'll stand
there with his arms folded. But no, I think Mark Henry wins.
Okay.
So another match that's been bumped to the pre-show is the Usos, Jimmy and Jay, against the Dudley Boys.
Yeah, okay.
This match has really just been sort of the Dudleys turned heel,
which is good.
Which is good. They're much better as heels.
Mm-hmm.
And they obviously needed a team to feud with.
Yep.
And Usos aren't doing anything.
Yep, that's true.
And so they've put them both together.
Yeah.
Probably why this match has been bumped to the pre-show.
Yeah, I don't think many people really care. There's not really been much of a feud.
No, I think that's fair what you're saying. I don't think many people care about this match. I'm one of those people.
Yeah,
I mean, they could have a good match. I mean, I like the Usos. They're good in-ring.
Yeah.
And I like the Dudleys. Same. Good in-ring. Yeah. Legends and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah, I'm sure it'll be a good match. I just don't care.
Yeah.
It's like 4 hours long. 6 hours if you count the Lily Priest show.
So who do you think is going to win that match?
Probably the Usos.
You think the Usos will win?
Yeah, because Dudley's job so far has been put people over, so Usos.
Yep, fair enough. I agree with you. I think I'm going to go with the Usos as well.
Okay.
To win. It is really a nothing match.
Pretty much.
I hope it's a good match. Like, I hope all the matches are good. just to keep us sort of entertained.
Yeah, for the 6 hours. Oh, God.
Yeah. it might be cool, actually, if they do get the SmackDown guys to maybe do the pre-show commentary.
Yeah, I think they did on last pay-per-view, whatever that was.
Really?
I think so.
Oh, okay, that's cool. So that'll be really good.
Yeah.
Okay, so coming off the back of Raw, we know Eva Marie joined the Total Divas.
Yeah.
So that match is also on the pre-show.
Okay. I kind of expect it would be.
Four matches on the pre-show is a lot.
It is.
So what is going to happen on the main card could be very interesting.
Yeah.
But so the Total Divas versus Bad and Blonde.
Yeah, stupid name.
Which is Naomi, Tamina, Lana, Emma, and Summer Rae.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a 5-on-5, 10 Diva tag team match.
Okay.
This
is just like, I feel like this is just like a, we've got all these Divas left, so we need to do something with them. Yeah. To have a tag match. It seems to happen every year.
Yeah, I mean, this has been your throwaway Divas segment on Raw that you probably all fast forward.
Yeah, pretty much.
I know I do, pretty much.
Yeah. Got some good wrestlers in there, like Paige and Emma, really good. Summer is better than people we've got it for.
Yeah, Emma's good.
Yep. Naomi's really good.
Yeah, Naomi's good. I mean, this is the first time you're going to see Lana competing in ring.
Yeah, that's cool. That could be interesting.
The rumour is that Brie Bella is actually going to retire the night after WrestleMania 32.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, something to do with Daniel Bryan's health that hasn't really been discussed in depth.
Yeah, I think they want to start a family and stuff. And
yeah, sure.
Imagine it's going to get in the way.
Yeah, of course. So maybe the Total Divas win. Brie and Lana have been the focal point for this feud, it would seem. That's why this match has sort of come together, because Lana kept interrupting Brie's matches and stuff like that. My prediction for this is the Total Divas win.
Yeah, same here.
Brie goes over Lana.
Yeah, that makes sense. Gives Brie her final little WrestleMania moment before leaving. And
yeah,
good guys normally win. Maybe Eva will turn heel during this at some point. Because nobody likes her anyway. But yeah, I think Total Divas win.
If Eva was to turn heel during this, I think Lana then goes over Brie.
Okay.
Brie wins in a singles match the night after on Raw.
Yeah, that makes sense. That makes sense as well. But we'll say Total Divas for now.
And we've discussed this match in way too much depth.
We have. I almost thought I got my chair. I've also gone to sleep because we've talked about it too long.
Yeah. And the final match on the pre-show. Mm-hmm. So we're both saying the Total Divas are going to win.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So the final match on the pre-show is Kalisto versus Ryback for the United States Championship.
Yay.
I don't know if they bumped these matches to the pre-show because people really aren't that bothered by them.
Yeah, it could be that.
And, you know, people want all-out action and stuff they're going to care about for WrestleMania.
Yeah. I hope WrestleMania isn't like 50% audio music performances by people you've never heard of. Because they always build someone out to do some bloody music thing.
Yeah, there's always two theme songs for WrestleMania. They are usually both performed live on the show.
I hate that.
You're not a fan of that?
No.
I understand they want that Super Bowl type of presentation, because the Super Bowl obviously has the halftime show and things like that. So I get it. I do, but
yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
it is what it is.
I'm not a music person.
Fair enough. So Kalisto versus Ryback then for the US title.
Yeah.
What do you think about this match?
I don't care. It's another thrown together match because Kalisto didn't have anyone to fight. Ryback didn't have anyone to fight. Come fight together. Why not? And yeah, it's like little guy versus big guy. I've seen it before with Rey Mysterio. I don't think Ryback has enough talent to make this match any good. Kalisto is great. Hopefully Kalisto can make Ryback look good somehow, but yeah, I'm not a Ryback fan.
I don't think anyone is.
No. I think Kalisto is going to win this.
Do you really?
Yeah.
My prediction is Ryback for this.
Oh, okay. Why's that?
I think Ryback's going to win because people are starting to, it's starting to wear thin. Kalisto's got a lot of fans based on sort of the mask thing, and he's marketed very much at children, much like Rey Mysterio was during his WWE run.
True.
Ryback, no one really cares about, and people need a reason to care about him. At least that's WWE logic. Thinking. So I don't know if maybe putting the US title on Ryback gives him a little bit of momentum going forward, perhaps. Okay.
Yeah, sure.
And then they'll have a rematch as whatever the next pay-per-view is, which Ryback will also win. And then the Lucha Dragons get back together and crack on when the tag team division stuff is back up and running.
Sure, that makes sense. I think at least it's going to win because, I don't know, I just hope WWE are listening to the fans, which they're not. So, yeah, you probably won't. But I'll stick with Kalisto for now.
Okay, fair enough. Okay, so I mean, so after 2 hours of the pre-show, I mean, these matches, they aren't going to be long matches because if you've ever watched the WrestleMania pre-show, they like to pad it out with other stuff.
Yeah.
So they're talking and hype videos for the matches that are actually going to be on WrestleMania, and they will throw these sort of 10-minute matches in between.
Yeah.
Which, you know, shows how much WWE cares about these matches.
Mm-hmm.
One, because they've been moved to the pre-show, and, well, actually, just because they've been moved to the pre-show, that should tell you what you need to know about these matches.
Pretty much.
They're very much throwaway matches. Okay, so we now move on to the main card,
mm-hmm.
which, now that these other matches have actually been moved out of it, actually looks like a very good wrestling show on paper.
Sure.
But there is only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 matches on WrestleMania.
7 hours.
Now, bear in mind, this is a 4-hour show.
Yeah.
So you are going to get your musical performances. I'm sorry.
I'll just go to the bathroom at that point, don't I?
You're going to get
pee break.
A 45-minute Triple H entrance.
Yeah, that's true.
Same for The Undertaker.
Yeah.
I mean, WrestleMania is such a big deal. So, I mean, obviously all the stops are, you know, pulled out and, you know, everyone has a big sort of extravagant entrance, especially sort of the matches that are a big deal. Like Cena, Rusev last year when they did the bloody Patriots things. And
the tag was cool.
Yeah, it was cool. And Triple H had that weird Terminator entrance.
That was stupid.
Very stupid. And Sting had some weird Japanese guys playing drums and stuff.
That was alright.
It would have been better if it was at night time.
Yeah, definitely. During the day, it just looks... Especially the Undertaker entrance as well. During the day, it just doesn't make any sense.
No, it's lost.
Yeah.
It's lost in the daytime. I'm assuming this one's at night.
I hope so.
Yeah, I hope
so too. Or indoors, one or the other.
Because I know the stadium there, the stadium in Dallas that they're fighting at, well, they're having the event, sorry, fighting at, it does have a retractable roof, so.
Okay, so,
it's an NFL stadium, I know, it does have a retractable roof.
Okay, put the roof up then, and you'll be sorted.
Yeah. I do like the outdoors, though. It feels like WrestleMania when it's outdoors.
Does it? I don't know.
You're not a fan of outdoors?
No, it's kind of, I don't know. It's.
It makes it different.
It does make it different, but, I don't know, I don't like change. But
it's okay for once a year, though.
Yeah, I guess.
It just, I don't know, it adds more to the atmosphere outside, I think.
Yeah, sure. Just make it night time.
And apparently they've sold out now as well, actually. I saw that earlier on today. Oh, apparently the event is actually sold out.
Great.
I know they were maybe struggling to sort of shift them final few thousand, but they've sold out and the crowd's going to be bloody massive, so.
Yeah.
So, let's work through the WrestleMania card and give our predictions for that. Cool. So, AJ Styles versus Chris Jericho.
Mm-hmm.
This obviously has been building up for a while since AJ came in at the Royal Rumble. They had sort of 3 matches together, which AJ came out on top of. The final one was at Fastlane, is that right?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
They've somehow managed to get a hell of a lot of life out of this feud since then.
Yeah. I mean, they've had, 3 really good matches. I kind of figured it would be the end of it now. I'm sure it's going to be another good match at Mania.
Yeah.
Do kind of wish it was against someone else other than Jericho, though. Mm-hmm. Not gonna lie. But it'll be good, either way. I like Jericho as a heel.
Yeah, he's is Jericho's good. Best work for years. Years and years.
He's very good. So yeah, it's worth watching for that, I guess.
Okay, I only see one winner.
Yeah, me too.
So AJ Styles, I think, wins.
Yeah, for sure.
And I think then after that he'll move on to sort of something else.
Yeah,
definitely. Maybe if Owens keeps hold of the IC title, he'll go after that, which would be great because I know they've been having matches on Raw and stuff and SmackDown the last few weeks.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I think that's going to be a great match.
For sure.
Potential show stealer.
Yeah, could be.
There's a few of those though.
True.
Kevin Owens is defending his Intercontinental Championship in a 7-man ladder match.
Yes.
So it's Kevin Owens versus Sami Zayn versus Dolph Ziggler versus Zack Ryder versus Sin Cara versus The Miz versus Stardust.
Yes.
This has been thrown together due to injuries because, you know, Neville would have been in it.
He's been so good. Poor Neville.
I don't know who's going to win. I mean, there's going to be a lot of high spots in this match.
For sure.
Sin Cara will go flying around. Dolph Ziggler will do a ton of, you know, real hard-looking bumps.
Yeah. Famous up the top of that, wasn't he?
Sami Zayn is excellent. Kevin Owens is outstanding.
Yeah.
So this is another potential show stealer.
Yeah.
How do you see it going?
I think it'll be either Sami or Kevin Owens to win it, I think, because they'd like the most two over. You'd be like, one, the only two people you have to care about.
Yeah. I mean, this match came about through those two, really.
For sure. I think he should have just been Owens and Sami in a ladder match and just not everyone else, personally. But
I think the reason they've put a ladder match on is because there's a lot of singles matches on the card.
That's true. Yeah, that's true. I guess it just makes it a bit different, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, but we don't see anyone else winning. I want to say Sami Zayn. It's more like a feel-good moment of like Sami actually winning.
I would love that so much.
Yeah.
I would be so happy with that outcome.
Mm-hmm.
Sadly, I don't think that's going to happen.
No.
I think WWE have got so much stock in Kevin Owens. They Triple H is such a fan of Kevin Owens.
Yeah, that's true.
And Kevin Owens is an amazing heel and an amazing in-ring competitor. So I think Kevin Owens keeps hold of the title.
Okay.
After an excellent match.
Yeah, I'm sure it'll be good. But yeah, it could go either way, as I said. I bet you think Sam's going to do it. So we'll see.
We will see.
We'll see.
The New Day. So all three of them, Big E, Kofi, and Xavier Woods, taking on all four members of the League of Nations. Amazingly, they're all fit at the same time.
Hooray.
So Sheamus, Del Rio, Rusev, and Wade Barrett.
Okay.
Who they are still calling King Barrett.
For some reason.
I do hope they have another King of the Ring tournament this year, actually, because I like the idea of it.
Yeah, just don't give the winner a King gimmick, for God's sake.
Yeah, you just don't need to.
No, there's no need.
Can you imagine if Stone Cold had got a King gimmick after he won the 96 King of the Ring?
Yeah, just came down with a cape and scepter.
Yeah,
King Stone Cold.
Yeah. Ugh. King Austin.
Yeah,
since I just royally whipped your ass.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's bottom line, because the King said so.
Yeah. It's a rubbish thing to do.
It is. It's crap. It hasn't worked ever, so...
No.
Don't do it.
So the tag team titles are not on the line at WrestleMania this year.
Really?
Yep.
Oh. Okay.
That's so that match is
weird
not choice. A title match.
Weird. I thought it was.
No. Nope.
Bizarre. Okay. Then, yeah, who cares?
Why not? I mean...
We knew they're going to win, obviously.
I've not really been a big fan of this feud. I really like the New Day. They are amazingly over.
I love them, yeah.
They're so over. Like, I saw a fan-filmed video from their promo on Raw.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, the what you hear on Raw isn't what you would hear in real life if you were at the event.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
So, as I'm sure you can hear, sort of, crowd reactions have moved up and down during, like, chants start breaking off, and then obviously you can hear the crowd more. And the video that I saw, like, was them doing the Bootios thing, and, like, the crowd were going ballistic for it.
Yeah.
It's just, yeah, the New Day are so over at the minute that I can't see them losing.
No, I can't. They're losing League of Nations, who I said which no one cares about.
I know. Individually, they're all good.
They are, yeah.
Collectively, who cares?
Yeah. The WWE was really good, underrated. But yeah, as I said, all of them are really good. Wade Barrett's leaving as well after this, so it wouldn't make much sense.
Is he leaving fresh after WrestleMania, or is it sort of...
I don't know, to be honest, but you know, he's leaving soon.
They've all just got new t-shirts.
That's true. Yeah.
The same design, just with a different flag on it, and a different, which sucks. Surely no one's bought that.
No, I can't imagine they would. Why you would? But.
Yeah, I know. So I mean, this has come about over the last few weeks. New Day have come out and done a promo. The League of Nations have come out and interrupted. Fights have ensued. They fought for the tag team titles at Roadblock.
They did.
New Day obviously came out on top.
Mm-hmm.
I see no difference here.
Yeah, I agree.
Because New Day rocks.
Yeah, because New Day rocks.
Yeah.
New Day rocks, etc.
Yeah. So yeah, I think New Day win. Are we in agreement with that?
Yep, absolutely.
Okay.
100%.
I think that'll be a good match though. I mean, it has potential. I mean, all of the guys in that match are good.
Yeah, I mean, that match away was good. So
yeah, it was good. Yeah.
I don't see why this would be any different.
At least no, you can't have any crappy interference with this.
That's true, yeah.
So, I mean, it's just literally going to be, you know, them fighting each other 4-on-3.
Yeah.
So that'd be pretty cool.
Yep.
I saw a rumour that, well, somebody's prediction, more than a rumour, that The Rock could get involved in this.
Really?
Yeah.
All right, sure.
Because he had that thing with New Day on Raw a few weeks back.
That's true.
And obviously there's 4 of the League of Nations and only 3 of the New Day.
Okay, yeah. It'd be weird, but sure. I wouldn't be against it.
I mean, I don't see that happening. I thought it was an interesting little theory on, because The Rock's going to be involved somehow at WrestleMania. We don't know how. Maybe that could be an interesting theory of how we could get involved. I don't think that will be the case, but why not?
Yeah, why not?
Sure. In fact, let's talk, before we go on to the Divas title match, let's talk about The Rock for a second.
Okay.
What do you think The Rock is going to do at WrestleMania?
I don't know.
Right.
I don't know, but I just thought it'd be like cutting a promo of some kind, maybe choosing a match at SummerSlam or something, where the next big event is. I don't know. Maybe it'll be in some sort of match. Maybe we'll do another thing with the Authority, like last year he did with Ronda Rousey. Maybe we'll be something like that again. Maybe Ronda Rousey will be there as well.
Maybe.
She's been seen in a while. So, who knows?
Okay, fair enough. I mean, I hadn't really given too much thought to it. Yeah. I've been hyping it up quite a lot that The Rock's going to be there.
That's true.
But I don't really know at this point. I like The Rock. It's always cool to see The Rock. He always has something funny to say. It would be cool to see him get involved with the New Day. But at the same time, it'd be maybe cool to see him get involved in the main event somehow.
Yeah.
But I'm not sure how.
Yeah. Weird one.
It is a weird one. Okay, so Charlotte versus Sasha Banks versus Becky Lynch for the WWE Divas Championship.
This is another one that has potential to be show stealing.
Yes.
If they give them time, which hopefully they will. They've got 4 hours to fill, so they should.
Yeah. I think every match is going to get a decent amount of time.
Yeah. Who do I think is going to win that one? I think Sasha's going to win that.
I do as well. This could be amazing.
It could.
Given the work that all three of these ladies have sort of put on NXT and the matches they had with each other on there, you know, this is what the Divas division should be.
Absolutely.
Apart from that, it shouldn't be called the Divas division. It should drop it. Should be called the women's division, like it is on NXT.
Yep, I agree.
It shouldn't really be any different, just make it consistent.
Yep, bring back the old belt or make a new belt.
Yeah, the old belt was fine.
Yeah, yeah.
It was good. It's not really, apart from colours, it's not too dissimilar to the NXT title, really.
No.
The old one.
Pretty much.
Maybe that's what they're going to go for after this.
Hopefully.
Because Divas Revolution is a stupid term.
It is.
And, you know, everyone is in agreement that it should be called the women's division. I mean, bloody hell, on NXT they chant women's wrestling.
Exactly, yeah.
And that's exactly what it is. It's women's wrestling, not divas wrestling.
No.
I think, I'm a big Sasha Banks fan anyway.
Shame.
And I have been for a while, so I would like to see Sasha Banks win, and it makes sense as well.
Yeah, yeah. She won against Charlotte clean on SmackDown a little while ago. So I could probably be teasing it as well.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, but as you said, they're all amazing. Wrestlers, so whoever wins, we're all winners. I think Sasha can win because it's the most popular by far.
Oh, by mile. But this is the match that everyone wants to see
for sure
as far as the Divas division goes.
I
can't wait for that, and I've not been able to say that for a women's match on the main roster for a long time.
I always get
hyped for the women's matches on NXT. But never on the main roster.
No.
But this one, I'm very excited for.
Yeah, it'll be great.
So we're both saying Sasha's going to win.
Yep, definitely.
Okay. All right, so Dean Ambrose versus Brock Lesnar in a no-holds-barred street fight.
Yep. It's
be good. The hardest match to call on the card.
For sure. The
build-up's been okay.
Yeah, that's probably the best build-up out of anything, except maybe the women's match.
Yeah, I feel like it's sort of been fast-tracked a little bit since Roadblock.
Yeah. That's true, because they did the thing with him fighting Triple H and kind of forgot about it for a while, and then, oh no, we're back I hate to say it again.
Yeah. Right, oh, he's lost now, it's time for him to go fight Brock.
Yeah.
Which is, that's fine though, they've had some good build up, there's good sort of tension there, so that for sure has the potential to be excellent.
Yeah.
I like Dean, I like Brock.
Yep.
A win would benefit Ambrose more.
Yeah, I agree. That was my thought as well. If they want to get Brock's heat back, they can just have him attack again after the match. Or do something on Raw and have him attack Dean. Like, maybe Dean comes down and cuts a promo and then just Brock comes down and beats the crap out of him or something.
Because I feel like Brock's been very much used like a spectacle.
Yeah, pretty much.
Like, oh, here's Brock fighting in Japan. And yeah. Brock's going to fight on a house show now and that sort of thing. So he's been used as like a special attraction more than a serious threat.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, obviously, I know he had his title run, which was good. Then, obviously, he lost it to Seth Rollins at last year's WrestleMania. Never got it back.
That's true.
And he hasn't really done anything sort of worth doing since then.
No. But, yeah. Not really sure what the stakes are on this. Like, will they get a title shot afterwards if they win? Who knows?
That's true.
Why are they even fighting in the first place? Who remembers? But who cares? Where's it be good?
No, I can't remember either. I don't even know why they're fighting. I know I'm just excited for it.
Yeah.
Because... Did they have a triple threat match?
I think Dean cost Brock in some match somehow. Oh, was it the Royal Rumble? Did he eliminate Brock in the Royal Rumble?
No, the Wyatts did.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I don't know. I can't remember. we'll research it and come back to you.
Yeah. What was the pay-per-view after the Royal Rumble? Fastlane.
Fastlane, yeah.
What was the main event of Fastlane?
Oh, yeah, Triple Threat. Dean versus Brock versus...
Reigns for the number one contenders.
Yeah.
That's it, that's why. That was it,
okay, yeah.
Got it, right,
good. You remembered, hooray.
Hooray. I don't know who wins. I mean, I'm going to go with Dean Ambrose winning.
Yeah, I think I will as well. It would make more sense. It would show that Dean can... stand in the main event and is the potential threat for the title.
Yeah.
And Brock won't be damaged too much by losing to Dean, especially since weapons are involved and things.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
So, maybe
he chops his leg off with that chainsaw. Terry Funk over.
That'd be crazy.
That makes the most sense.
For sure.
It won't damage Brock, but it will enhance Dean's status in the main event scene.
Absolutely. I agree.
Okay. Dean Ambrose, that's good. Okay, and now we move on to by far the most interesting match on the card.
Yes.
Shane McMahon versus The Undertaker in a Hell in a Cell match. If Shane wins, he will get control of Raw and it will be Undertaker's last WrestleMania.
Mm-hmm.
So this has had interesting build-up. Nobody saw it coming.
No, nobody.
Us, nobody. Everyone was just guessing at what Undertaker's main event, WrestleMania match was going to be. Nobody thought it was going to be against Shane McMahon.
No.
So when Shane came back on Raw and Vince dropped that bomb that, you know, when Shane came back and he was like, oh, I want control of Raw. Not SmackDown, because SmackDown sucks, but I want control of Raw.
Just Raw, mostly.
Just Raw. Not main event, not anything else, just Raw. So Vince said, right, okay, well, you can have your chance to have your share of the family fortune and blah, 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 and take control of Raw. But you've got to beat The Undertaker at WrestleMania.
Yeah.
And everyone's like, oh my God.
Yeah.
Oh my God, what is... What? Why? I wake up the day after and I text friend of the show, Steve, about this match. And he was fuming. Like, the text I got back was, this is bullshit.
Nice. Not happy then.
He warmed to it afterwards. I mean, I was shocked, mainly.
Yeah.
Really shocked.
I was done.
But, you know, they've made Shane look legitimately bad.
Yeah, he seems like a threat now.
Like a real, like, oh, why is Shane going to fight The Undertaker? What's the point of Undertaker just beat him?
Yeah.
I didn't see it like that. But I didn't anyway, because it's sort of like, Shane had all these awesome matches. He fought Kurt Angle, he's fought Kane, he's fought The Big Show, and, you know, hardest of all, he fought Steve Blackman.
Yeah.
You know, Shane is tough.
He is.
He's a legitimate tough guy. And he's, as we alluded to earlier on, he is bloody stacked.
Yeah, he's great.
So, fair play for a 40 whatever hour audience.
46, 47?
Yeah, he's absolutely stacked.
He's great.
So fair play. Okay, so the stakes are Shane McMahon wins, he gets control of Raw.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. They've been very specific with that. Raw.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
that indicates that Shane McMahon would run Raw and somebody else would run SmackDown.
Yeah. Which would be cool.
Which, based on rumor, based on reading maybe too much into it, that is what makes perfect sense.
Yeah. Because they've recently moved SmackDown to the USA Network in America, which is, I think, is more popular than what it was on before.
Was it on Sci-Fi?
Ah, who knows. But
it was on before Sharknado every week on Sci-Fi.
That's true. But yeah, I think they want to elevate SmackDown to what it was before, back when he used to compete with Raw.
Yeah.
Just makes sense. Days. And also, it would split the roster a bit and give guys like more time off between events, so less injuries possibly, and things like that.
You know, I hadn't even thought of it like that, but that is very smart.
Yeah. Not my thought, sadly, but I'd read that somewhere. But it makes sense because so many people are injured at the minute.
That makes perfect sense because you can have separate shows. And obviously, SmackDown's only once a week. Raw's only once a week. It gives a bit of time to recover between shows. You know what? That makes perfect. I hadn't even thought of it like that. But
yeah.
That makes perfect sense. So, I mean, obviously on episode 7 of our show, you said that The Undertaker would win.
Yes, because I thought he would have another Mania match. Because I thought I remembered it wrong, I thought Vince said he would never wrestle again, full stop, but he didn't. He just said he'd never wrestle at Mania again. So he will wrestle again.
So WrestleMania's in Texas this year.
Yeah.
Undertaker's from Texas. Mm-hmm. It makes perfect sense for him to ride off into the WrestleMania sunset in Texas.
Yeah, definitely. So, yep, I think it would make perfect sense to change a win. Something needs to happen. It's a shame to give Undertaker another loss at WrestleMania. But
like Shane pointed out on Raw, Undertaker wrestling at WrestleMania now doesn't matter.
Yeah, it has less impact now than it used to.
Yeah, it's like, I mean, this is the first Undertaker match I've cared about since he lost to Brock.
Yeah, true.
Didn't care about him fighting Bray Wyatt. Who did he fight last year? Or was that Bray Wyatt last year?
It was Bray Wyatt last year, wasn't it?
And who was it the year before that? Was that when he lost to Brock?
Yeah, I think so. It's Brock, then Wyatt, then this year, right? Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So like when Undertaker wins and they have the 22-1 on the screen, it means nothing now because we don't need to put the score up anymore because it's irrelevant because he's lost a match.
Yeah.
You know? So... I think Shane wins because change is needed, and I think WWE knows it.
Yep.
And I think they will do anything to sort of get interest back in the product again.
For sure.
And this would definitely do that. Especially both shows. I mean, I don't know what SmackDown does ratings-wise each week, but I can't imagine it's competing with the hottest shows on the USA Network.
No, don't think so. I think it's down pretty hard.
Yeah, and it would also sort of give... I mean, the US title is in need of maybe a revamp.
Mm-hmm.
It's not held any real credibility since Cena had it.
Yeah.
And did a very good job of it. So maybe move a couple of titles over to SmackDown. Give it its own identity, its own roster, and have it sort of competing against Raw.
That would make sense. I don't know if they're going to split the championship up again. That's two world champions. Maybe they just bring to have SmackDown for some of the smaller titles, like maybe bring back the Cruiserweight Championship. Are they going to do that event soon on the network?
Yep. Which on a little side note, you know, UK promotions are getting qualifying matches for the WWE Cruiserweight Series, which is great news for the UK independent scene.
So awesome!
And I think it shows how strong the scene is over here as well.
Yeah, it's crazy.
So maybe they could have that on. On SmackDown, I don't know how it's going to go. Obviously, everything is sort of guesswork. Ourselves and everybody else who does podcasts across the internet.
Yeah,
there's enough of them. But if you listen to ours, thank you very much. I do think Shane McMahon wins.
Yeah, I agree. I'll come round.
Not clean.
Probably not.
And here is where my NXT theory comes into this.
Okay.
Okay. So earlier on, obviously, we talked about NXT. And obviously, Finn Balor is due to come up to the main roster, apparently.
Mm-hmm.
So should he lose to Samoa Joe, which I think he will.
Uh-huh.
And with Carl Anderson now being at the Performance Center, and Doc Gallows main roster ready, because he's been there before.
Yep.
I think maybe the Balor Club, or whatever they're going to be called in WWE, I think they assist Shane in some way.
Okay. That'd be cool.
Potentially. I think that's what's going to happen, because there's no way that Shane can beat The Undertaker clean.
No.
And it doesn't make sense for the Wyatts to get involved again.
Nope. And half of them are injured anyway, so everybody couldn't.
Yep. So...
what are the Wyatts doing at Mania?
Nothing. They might actually be in the Andre the Giant Battle Royal.
Oh, right. Yeah, that makes sense, actually, yeah.
And if they are, Bray Wyatt wins it.
Yeah. You think he's still hurt, isn't he?
No. I think he's been fighting on house shows.
Oh, okay. That's fair enough then.
I don't think he's hurt anymore. I know he didn't compete on SmackDown, but it doesn't really matter.
Yeah.
Either way, I think Finn Balor and his friends get involved in the Undertaker versus Shane match and maybe cost the Undertaker the match.
That'd be cool. I'd love to see that.
Yes, it'd be very cool. I don't know whether that's going to happen again. This is just me sort of guessing, but it would be awesome.
Yeah. I kind of figured when they debuted, it would be as heels. But I don't know. You could be right. That could definitely happen. I'd love to see it. I'm sure.
Well, it depends how you view it. I mean, who's the heel and who's the face going into this?
Well, that's true. Yeah.
The crowd are going to cheer for both. Yeah. The crowd want change, yet the crowd loves The Undertaker and it's in Texas.
Yeah.
So, do the heels cost The Undertaker the match, or do they, or are they faces and they, you know, there's different ways to look at it. So yeah,
that's true, actually.
You're either the heels who cost the match or the heels who help win the match. It depends on your view on who's the heel.
Yeah.
So I think, because there's no way Shane goes over clean, so something has to happen.
Yeah, I agree.
It's too obvious for the Wyatts to get involved.
Yeah, definitely.
And it makes no sense because no one wants to see Undertaker versus Bray Wyatt.
Yeah, and it's been done to death with the Wyatts coming in and just doing nothing with the feud.
Exactly. So that's what I think is going to happen. And I think they help Shane win the match.
Yep.
And take control of Raw.
Sounds good. Well, that's it. I hope you're right.
We're both going for Shane to win that match.
For sure.
They could come back and be egg on our faces. All right. So the main event doesn't really need to be spoken about a great deal.
Nope.
There's only going to be one winner. And that's Roman Reigns.
Roman Reigns.
Unless WWE sees, they should see, because it's been happening since Royal Rumble last year.
Yeah.
That Roman Reigns is not very popular.
He's not.
And that isn't going to change.
It's not.
It's not going to change at all, okay? I like Roman Reigns.
He's fine.
Yeah, he's fine. But I also like Triple H.
Yep.
Triple H being the champion doesn't work for me because he doesn't wrestle enough.
No.
But Roman Reigns being the champion isn't going to work for the WWE long term. Because I put this on Twitter yesterday, I think, or after I'd watched Raw, that Roman Reigns isn't like now. He isn't going to be liked when he wins the championship. And it's going to get to a point where the crowd is just going to boo him week in and week out until eventually they get bored and he gets no reaction at all.
Yeah.
And that is going to cause a problem for WWE.
It is. The only change I can see happening is, I can't even see that, but somehow turning Roman heel after Mania, because then they would need to make sense that he's getting booed.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know how they would do that. Yeah, it's a sticky situation.
WWE must be surely aware of the repercussions of Roman Reigns winning the title.
Yeah.
Last year, they had a get-out clause because Seth Rollins had Money in the Bank.
That's true.
They screwed Money in the Bank up and had Sheamus win it and had him cash in. And now it's faded away and it's a distant memory that everybody has tried to, forget.
Yeah.
They don't have that out this year.
They don't.
So it's either not Roman Reigns wins clean and make Roman Reigns look strong, which everybody's going to boo.
Yeah, everybody.
Regardless of the outcome of this match, because Roman Reigns is going to win, the crowd are going to boo.
Yeah.
Big time.
Yeah. Even no matter of The Rock coming out and helping, he's going to help.
Yeah, so even if The Rock does get involved in this and, has his You know, I mean, helping Roman Reigns win the match probably makes Roman Reigns look worse, like you said earlier on.
Yeah, it does.
It actually makes him look worse because he's had to cheat to win.
Yeah. But who knows? Maybe someone else gets involved on Triple H's side and then Rock comes down and stops the people who are helping Triple H.
Part of me wants to believe that there's something planned to make the outcome less painful for us all.
Yeah. If there's a time to do it, it'll be at WrestleMania.
Yeah. But, you know, so there is part of me that wants that. And, well, in fact, all of me wants that.
Yeah, yeah.
And there's part of me that thinks that WWE may come up with something. But, you know, there is that part of me also that has been watching this long enough for me to sort of understand that...
You probably won't.
If Vince McMahon wants something, he's going to get it. And he wants Roman Reigns as the champion.
Yeah. For some reason.
And he's old. He could very well go over clean.
Yeah.
Imagine the reaction when he goes over clean.
He won't be ready.
I can't wait for our reaction when he goes over clean.
Yeah. We should that's been my camera that I film my reactions too. That's like edit line, like a little montage of stuff.
That might be a good shout actually.
Yeah, I might do that. I think I can probably plug into your little laptop and
Yeah,
we'll do that. We'll look forward to that on YouTube.
Yeah. Our reactions to WrestleMania. We'll have like a little montage.
Yeah.
Roman Reigns wins. I'm going to predict clean because I don't know if WWE is going to throw us a curveball. So, Roman Reigns.
Yeah, same. Yeah. What else is there to say, really?
Well, that's it, yeah.
We hope something happens, but it won't. So,
yeah.
The end.
There will be a reaction to this from us. We'll follow this podcast up. Maybe next week we'll sort of reconvene after Raw.
Yep, we can do that.
And discuss sort of what happened the night after WrestleMania. We'll discuss the NXT fallout, WrestleMania fallout, and Raw post-WrestleMania fallout.
Yeah.
Okay.
Another bonus episode.
So thank you for persevering with us for nearly 2 hours of the Sonny and Finn WrestleMania special.
There you go. Thank you much. If you stayed this long, thanks.
Yep.
Bye.
Look out for our streams this week. We are going to do one for the NXT Takeover Dallas.
Yep.
On Friday. We'll do a WWE 2K16 stream to YouTube. So we can interact with you all.
Yep.
The same for WrestleMania on Sunday as well.
Yep.
Go follow us on Twitter at SonnyFinnPC. Go listen to our other podcasts. Go watch our videos on YouTube.
Yep. Links in the description.
And go like and subscribe to all of our other stuff as well. So thank you very much for listening. So from Sonny and Finn, we will speak to you next time. Enjoy WrestleMania.
Thank you very much. Goodbye. Bye.